This one is El Yucateco,
what's
Caribbean
your fucking
Habanero.
Deal?
What's my deal?
I don't know, but what is your deal? I don't know. What do you do? What are you about? Where do you come from? How do you? Like, what are you about? What do you do?
Just a dude that eats wings and interviews famous people. That's it.
Come on, there's more substance to you.
I'm not an interesting
story. I see
story.
Substance in you.
What's the tallest girl you ever dated? Be honest.
When I was in eighth grade, I dated this volleyball chick that was like 5'10", but I was like 5'3" or something at the time. And then on the cover, of like the eighth grade paper, there's like a picture from the eighth grade dance, and we're slow dancing, and I'm around her hips, and she is like, I'm at like her waist. My mom bought every copy of the paper. Yeah. Like at graduation, came home and just a box of those papers. She was so proud, but it's the most ridiculous picture.
Were you a wing guy before the show?
I mean, who isn't at some level? Whatever, but like at this point, like, it's hard for me to even look at a chicken wing.
I wouldn't know it. You really look like you're enjoying yourself over there.
I'm blessed to have this like goofball job, like this cartoon existence that I have going, but.
I remind myself of that every single morning, by the way.
You eat and eat so regular, like, is your wings the same thing as mine?
We can switch the paddles if you want, Ferg. I'm down for whatever you want to do, but I think it's just, I've done this week over week. This is now my life.
Your doodle must be hot.
The shit's hot. The shit's hot.
You're really good with the fucking spice.
What if I was bad? Well, you know what I mean?
That's true.
I can't be bad.
Is there a story behind why you're so good at this?
I'm not really, I don't have like any like hot sauce roots or anything. We just were like, celebrity interviews are boring. How do we make them not boring? And our solve for that was hot sauce, you know? So I wasn't a hot sauce guy before. I just had to become one quickly, you know?
Does it ever get hot for you?
It's horrible. How do you do this for a living?
Does it ever faze you?
So I'm human, you know? I'm no superhero. The sauces, they hit me, but what it really comes down to is it's better than having a real job.
Does water help?
So, I always have this thing, when I hit the water, I know that fans are gonna be like, that actually makes it worse, that spreads the capsaicin around. No, I know, but like, so I have, like, there's tons of insufferable hot sauce experts that are always hitting me with the tips
so
and the tricks.
So you're trolling them?
Maybe on some level, but also I think psychologically, which I think is more important anyway, the water does help me for whatever reason. I know that it's against science, but in my brain, that's how it works.
Okay. Did he drink milk?
Listen.
Why did he drink milk?
Because I have nothing to prove, all right? Philly, you come in here, you get through it without some milk, your whole team's giving you high fives or whatever. Do this 108 times, all right? And then don't drink the milk.
Look, you're getting a little... Are you okay?
I mean, listen, I'm no superhero, Henry. I've done this a lot, but like, you know, whatever. I'm human. These hot sauces, they affect me.
I'm glad you know that you and I can hit that human note.
It's a shared struggle.
Yeah, together, the two of us. Yeah, in a room full of people off camera.
Exactly.
Let me ask you a question, buddy.
Sure.
Yeah, let me ask you a question.
Uh-huh.
Whose idea was the show?
So, see that guy right there? In the blue shirt?
Yeah?
His name's Chris.
What's your name, Chris, right? Can you fight Chris?
You might have to, buddy.
We have to talk about this. You got any other bright ideas coming up in your little brain box over there?
So what's he that, came bro? Up to me in like 2014, 2015. He's like, hey, I have this idea. What do you think about interviewing celebrities but having them eat increasingly spicy chicken wings as a way to break them down over the course of the interview?
That's fucking fire, man.
That's the story of Hot Ones.
Are you guys taking investors? Do you guys like let people invest? Yeah?
So I have an unhealthy reliance on carryout, and as our fans know, I have zero kitchen skills, but I would like to get better. So I'm hoping now I can bounce some common bachelor lifestyle cooking quandaries off you, and you can kind of give me some
tips,
guy
style. Is this, what is this, we call this the penguin?
I have lots of different things. The commenters
so I have
are
the one-liners,
like
and then you have the.
I have like the
hand moves. And can we put that to music? Could you guys break that down for me? Just wicka.
To me, I never really thought about the hand gestures as such a thing. I've always talked with my hands. I've always been like kind of known for that. But then when you're on the internet every day, everybody just kind of takes whatever you are and makes you that thing. So I'm like hand gesture guy. But I've never thought of myself as hand gesture guy. I don't think about these things while they're happening. When I do these big sweeps or whatever, it's just how I'm talking. The hands, they're very much idle hands. They work themselves. You know what I mean? Like, I don't think about it.
Has anybody ever told you You look like the little man on the Lord of the Rings.
Oh, man.
Spiegel. You look better than him, but...
Jesus Christ, that might be the meanest thing anyone's ever said to me.
No, related to him, not
the goblin? Not,
okay, you don't look like him, man.
Good
I
Lord.
Thought I was giving you him can't a compliment.
Take it. You thought you were giving me a compliment calling the me Spiegel from Lord of the Rings?
The guy's got eyes like Smokey Robinson. Come on, give me a break.
You get Justin Timberlake a lot?
You know what? I used to, and I appreciated it. Yeah. And I think as I've gotten older, I get it less.
Yeah, you're handsome.
Thank you, Eric.
You're a fucking hunk.
So this is a part of that show.
Has anybody ever told you?
Who are you gonna say I look like?
You look like a heterosexual version.
Okay.
Of Neil Patrick
Harris. Love that. That's top five. That's top five. You know who you look like to me. All right, Blake Griffin.
Why do you have the bottle?
We have one more wing to go.
Then what happens? Why are you shaking it like that?
Man, why are you doing that?
What are you doing?
Can this like physically like fuck you up? Do I have to be like
I've
worried?
Done this. If you're worried, what am I? I've done this like 100 times.
Do you think I'll die? Like, what's the worst thing that can happen?
You will not die. You will not die.
What if I do?
I would feel horrible about that. And it would take, you know, I don't think I could continue the show. So this one is Blair's Mega Death Sauce with Liquid Rage.
You go first.
Me go first?
You go first, but I'm a guess.
Okay.
Oh, shit. Why you got to make eye contact?
Oh, this hurt as hard as that last one.
So let me...
Never know. Don't BS me.
No, no. I think if you can handle this, you can handle any hot sauce in the world, Shag.
Shit! That's not normal.
No.
In fact, this fucking program's not normal. No. Have you ever killed anybody?
We haven't heard from Coolio in a long time.
Fucking hell.
Hey, what's going on? This is Sean Evans, and as you guys know, we've been caught in a little bit of a holding pattern here as we prepare for season 12. I've been locked inside, celebrities locked inside, and while we had a great time eating the wings of death over Zoom with Bert Kreischer, we have been thinking about and working on ways to get back to production the safest way possible. But like we promised, we will not leave you hanging. And to fill in the gaps, we're coming at you 4 weeks straight with a new limited series called Sean Tells a Story. And as the name would suggest, it's just me going back to the recesses of my mind and pulling out these little gems, these little trips down memory lane, these stories that I can't stop thinking about now that I'm stuck in this apartment for weeks on end.